everybody. How are you? My name is Karen, and I teach drawing and painting lessons here at the rec center. And I miss all of my students, and I cannot wait to see you guys again. I brought a friend with me, and his name is Jack the Plumber. He is going to help me. Hey, Jack.
Hi. Hi, everyone.
So I want to show everybody a couple simple ways to draw some animals. We all love animals, right, Jack?
Yep.
So I want to show everybody out of basic, simple shapes how to draw a few animals, and I hope they're your favorites. My first one is my all-time favorite animal. Can you guess what that is, Jack?
It'd be an elephant.
An elephant. An elephant. So all you need to draw is a piece of paper, a pencil, any type of pencil. I brought a wipe-off board to show you, and I brought some examples as well. But you just need a pencil, any type of paper. I use Jack's computer paper, his printer paper, because he has about 10 boxes of computer paper. And anyhow, it's nice and easy, an eraser, a pencil, and a piece of paper. Now, later on, you can use markers, you could use crayons, you could use colored pencils, whatever you want. I just want everybody to use their imaginations. Are you guys ready? Are you ready, Jack? Okay. I am going to show you how to make these elephants out of two circles. A smaller circle and a bigger circle. And they don't have to be perfect circles. We don't want them to be perfect circles. So we're going to turn this into this. And even Jack did an example for us right here. He called his elephant Mike the elephant. Okay, is everybody ready? Let's go. All right, so I'm gonna use my wipe-off board because I think it'll be a lot easier for everyone to see. So how we're gonna begin, and remember, I'm using this because I can erase and you can see better. But at home, just a pencil, an eraser, and a piece of paper. So we're going to start with a circle. Doesn't have to be a perfect circle, just a circle. And then we're going to make a bigger circle like that. And look, mine's not perfect at all. Okay, so how is that going to become an elephant? We are gonna start here and make our elephant leg. There's one. Then we're gonna go like this and make our other elephant leg. Then we might as well put the back legs in here. All right. So next, what do you think we need? How about an elephant ear? Do we need an elephant ear?
Sure.
Let's start like this. Now we got our elephant ear. How about a trunk? I'm gonna start like way up here. And we're gonna take our trunk down. And it gets bigger as it goes up. And of course he needs a tail, right?
Yeah, he needs a tail.
He needs a tail. Let's give him a tail. All right, so now we have an elephant. Now it's time for details. So I'm gonna get my eraser here. And if you're using a pencil at home, just take your pencil eraser. We're gonna erase these lines right here. And this one here. And this one. So now we got our elephant, and all he needs, or she, are some details. We got our elephant. Oh, I erased that right there. So let's start with some toenails for our elephant. Okay, how about an eye? Give our elephant an eye. I'm just going to make this a smiley face. And then, elephants are pretty wrinkly, right? And we don't want our elephant being in thin air. So there we go. We have our elephant. Now, I want to show you my board over here. And Jack's going to tell us some facts about elephants. Okay, so there's our elephant. Very simple. It took, what, about 2 minutes to make. We started with a circle, added our legs, added our trunk, our eyes, our ears, and our toenails. Now, look at that. So let's say I was using a pencil. What you can do with the pencil, since elephants have very wrinkly skin, is just scribble. Just scribble on your elephant, and then I'm gonna grab my pencil. I'm just gonna scribble like this, and then I'm gonna go the opposite direction. I'm sort of just scribbling all over my elephant. And then I'm gonna take my fingers, or you could take a cloth, and I'm gonna rub it out. Rub it out. Your fingers might get a little bit messy, but that's okay. And then I like to use highlighters. So I took a pink highlighter and colored him in pink, or her. Okay, now I'm gonna show you another elephant. Another simple elephant to make with two circles. Jack, do you wanna read any of the elephant facts?
Yeah, I'll give you the different species. There are three species of elephants: African savanna elephant, African forest elephant, and an Asian elephant. Elephants are the world's largest land animal. Elephants spend about 12 to 18 hours a day eating. They eat grass, twigs, leaves, plants, bamboo, roots, and fruit. That is about 200 to 400 pounds of food a day.
Wow, that's a lot of food.
Elephants also drink about 55 gallons of water a day. A baby elephant is called a calf and can weigh about 250 pounds. An adult elephant can weigh 5,000 to 14,000 pounds.
Oh my goodness, that's...
It can be 13 feet tall. Most wild elephants sleep standing up. If they lay down, it is usually only third or fourth day, and only for an hour or two. Why are elephants so big? Their ears help them to keep their body temperature down, to cool themselves down. Elephants cannot sweat like humans do, so they fan themselves with their ears.
Wow. Couple more elephant facts.
Why do elephants have tusks? Elephants' tusks are for lifting, for getting food, like the bark off of trees, for fighting and defending themselves. Also, they use their tusks to dig way down into the dirt to fill the water if the land is too dry from the drought. Elephant tusks are made of ivory. It is against the law to hunt elephants for their ivory tusk.
I did hear that.
If any hunter would hunt elephants, they would probably go to jail.
Good. They should go to jail. Thanks, Jack. Okay, so we're gonna do, we did a side facing elephant. Let's try again with two circles. We're gonna put our circles in a little bit of a different position. That sort of reminds me of a snowman. Does that remind you of a snowman?
Looks good to me from here.
Okay, so let's slide this over here. Maybe we can hold both up, okay, if you don't mind holding that up. What a great assistant. Okay, so I'm gonna start with a circle again. Now this time I'm not gonna intersect them. I'm gonna go like that. Okay, sort of kind of like a snowman. So I'm gonna turn this into an elephant, okay? I'm gonna start, I'm gonna bring one leg right there, and then I'm gonna bring his other leg here, and again, I'm gonna start here, oops, and make this leg come up, and then there's a fourth leg back here we really don't see. Okay, so you got his legs. How about we'll go for his trunk, right? Let's bring his trunk out here like that. And let's give him some ears. Okay, and how about two eyes? We only had one eye on the elephant with the side view. Let's give him two eyes right. Fix that up right there. I like to give my elephants eyelids. Okay, now you were talking about the elephant's tusks, right?
Yes, I was.
You were, I remember that. Okay, so let's give this elephant, there's one, and we'll do one right here, and we'll erase that. Okay, so now we got our elephant. I'm gonna use this eraser again. This is where your pencil eraser comes in. Let's erase right here. Right there. And we'll erase right here. And where his legs are, of course. Oh, we forgot his tail, Jack. We need to put his tail on. And erase right here. And I think we got it. Okay, let's give him some details now. Okay, let's give him these lines here. Like that. We could even give him some lines right here. And here. I like to give my elephants eyelashes. And we'll fix that up right there. Okay, oh, we still forgot the tail, Jack. He didn't remind me. And give him some toenails here. Or her. Is your elephant going to be a boy or a girl? Okay, and our elephant's not in thin air. Where's our elephant? Is our elephant at the zoo? Is our elephant out in the wild? Where is our elephant? Is our elephant in our backyard? Is he in our room? Isn't he in our living room watching TV with us? So again, here's another simple way to make a cute elephant. Okay, got this? Mm-hmm. All right. And then you could get more creative with your circles. So for this one, I just put the circles in different positions. So I put a circle right here, and I put a circle right here. And use your imagination. Is the sun out? Jack said that elephants get hot, so this elephant right here, he got some water and he's given himself a little bit of a shower. And like I said, I love to use highlighters for coloring. So you don't have to color the whole thing in, you could just outline it. And it looks really cool. Okay, so let's move on to a horse, a zebra, a unicorn, or a donkey. This shape right here, which is a cylinder, that shape can give you all of these animals. So we're gonna start with a cylinder. I know everybody knows what a cylinder is. And then we're gonna go with a thin triangle up here, and then like a flag triangle. And then two long triangles right here. And that will turn our drawing into a zebra, a unicorn, a horse, or even a donkey. So right here, I drew it out. I used a black marker, but I wanted to show everybody in blue, I highlighted this exact same shape. Okay, and then once you erase, you turn it into this horse. And then we drew a couple more horses. What's your favorite horse, Jack?
Palomino.
A Palomino horse. And Jack named his horse Banjo. My favorite horses, an Appaloosa or an Arabian. That's my favorite breed of horses. Okay, so do you want to read us some horse facts? And I'll switch this up.
All right, horse facts. There are 60 million horses in the world. A baby horse is called a foal and can stand almost immediately after being born. A male horse is called a stallion. A female horse is called a mare. A young male horse is called a colt, and a young female horse is called a filly. Ponies are small horses. Horses have bigger eyes than any other mammal on the land. Horses are plant and grain eaters, but love treats like apples and carrots.
Of course, apples and carrots.
Horses are plant and grain eaters, but love treats like apples and carrots, just as I said.
Right.
Horses can gallop about 27 miles an hour.
That's a long time. That's a lot of speed.
There are 300 breeds of horses. What is your favorite breed of horse? As we mentioned, mine is a Palomino, and what? Yours is an Arabian horse.
An Arabian. I also like Appaloosa horses, too. Wow, thanks. Okay, so if you could hold that up for me, that would be great. Okay, so remember, everybody knows what a cylinder is, right? Uh-oh, it fell down. Maybe hold it back little. All right. Okay, cylinder, right? A cylinder, just like that. Doesn't have to be perfect again, just like our circles weren't perfect. Okay, so we got our cylinder, and then we are going to take a big triangle up like that. Then this looks like a flag, right? Do you guys see it yet? Okay, then we're gonna start here, take another triangle, here, take another triangle. Doesn't look like a horse yet, right, Jack?
Not from over here.
Not from behind. Okay, so now we're gonna perfect it. We're gonna give our horse some details, all right? So, let's go, I'm gonna use my finger as an eraser, and we're gonna go like this and round our cylinder out, okay? And then we'll round the bottom out as well. And then the legs of a horse are a teeny bit tricky, but not too challenging. So we're gonna come down here and look, I'm just gonna do that and make the horse's hooves. And then I'm gonna put this little teeny sort of kind of like comma up here and just go up and I'll erase it. So, oops, that's not the eraser. Wipe off marker. So that was pretty easy. Okay, so there's one leg. Now let's get the other horse's leg. And again, I'm gonna start here with his hoof, and I'm gonna go like that, and take it up there, and take it up like that. And just erase a little bit with your pencil. Okay. I know we still have this going on here, but let's finish up the legs. Let's give the horse a back leg here. And do the hoof, that little comma, and just like that, pretty simple. And then we'll give another one more time, little comma, and go up like that. All right, it's starting to shape up. Let's see. Let's erase here. That was our cylinder. Okay, now what are we going to do up here? So we're going to start here, think of the shape of a horse. We're just gonna round it out. This is just giving us the cylinder and the triangles are just giving us proportion. And we're gonna go like that. Starting to look like a horse. And I'm gonna erase right here. Okay. Sort of looks like a weird animal right now. That's not the ear. Our horse needs an ear. Okay. And I'm gonna take this down and just wiggle my pencil or wipe off marker a little bit. Oops, we lost the example again. Lean it back just a little bit. Thank you. Okay, so let's give our horse another ear, right? And let's give our horse a mane. What kind of mane would you like to give your horse? Big flowing mane. What color is your horse gonna be? White. Let's name some colors of horses. There's brown. There's a lot of brown horses. Can you think of any, Jack?
Black.
Black. White horses.
Gray.
Gray. There's gray horses. Little. Okay. Now, I'm going to fix this up a little bit. You can make your mane however you want. Oh, we need a tail. Let's give our horse a tail. Get fun with it. Get creative with it. And once you got your horse down packed, you can give your horse a saddle. Maybe your horse needs a saddle. Color your horse in. And did you say horses have very big eyes?
Yes, I did.
I thought so.
Biggest eyes of all men.
Wow. Now I'm going to give my horse a smile. Now, you can also, I know we're doing cartoons right here, but you can also make with the same cylinder and the same triangles, you can make it look realistic. It's just a matter of shading with your pencils or whatever medium you're using, okay? But we're trying to make it fun, so we are making them cartoons. And like I said, I like to give eyelashes. So right there, you have a very simple horse, okay? Now, let's show some other horse pictures. Okay, are we ready for a zebra? Jack, do you want to read us some zebra facts?
Yes, I will.
You will. Okay, and remember, we're using the same cylinder, the same triangle, the same flag triangle, four triangles here. Maybe a little bit shorter on the neck. Okay. All right, let's hear it.
Zebra facts. Zebras are part of the horse family. Zebras have good eyesight and good hearing. Zebras live in plains and grasslands in southern eastern Africa. Zebra stripes help to camouflage them in the grasslands and the plains.
Wow.
Zebra stripes are unique to each zebra, similar to human fingerprints. Zebras can run as fast as 40 miles an hour, and zebras weigh about 520 to 900 pounds.
Wow.
Zebras eat grass and sometimes leaves, shrubs, twigs, and barks. Zebras sleep mostly standing up. Baby zebras can walk 20 minutes after being born.
20 minutes?
Are zebras white and black stripes or black with white stripes?
I don't know. What do you think?
Either.
Are they black with white stripes or white?
They're white with black stripes.
I don't know. That's pretty cool, though, that their stripes are unique to our fingerprints. I think that's really awesome. Okay. Let's work on some zebra stripes. Zebra stripes are super fun. Okay, again, this is how we're gonna start. I'm gonna go a little bit faster. Got my cylinder, I got my triangles. Here's one, two, three, four. Okay, now notice the zebra's mane is a little bit different. And so is the zebra's tail. Okay, so we're gonna curve that. Okay, I'm going to erase this. Just going to use my fingers as an eraser. Give the hooves over here. And then I'm going to wiggle my marker. You're going to wiggle your pencil, right? give it the hooves again. That's the back leg. Go up, wiggle it, erase right there. Again, for another back leg. Oops. We'll fix that up later. And then like that, so we get rid of our triangles. Okay, starting to look like a zebra, huh? Not really. Let's fix right here. Okay, and we did take this down a little bit. All right, so pretty much the same as a horse, okay? Like that, and we'll bring this down a little bit. Erase that flag right there. Little bit bigger ears. And then I like to do this. Okay, now we're gonna bring this, wiggle it. And I don't want that so straight, so I'm gonna erase that, wiggle it. And now we're just gonna add some black to the zebra's mane. And I think I touched that. Let's give our zebra an eye. I'm gonna give my zebra a fun eye. And some eyelashes, of course, like that. Oh, I forgot my zebra's tail. I'm gonna give my zebra a smile. Sort of like the elephant's tail, huh, Jack?
Just like it.
Yeah. Okay, so my zebra is white. And I'm gonna put black stripes on. These are so much fun to do, okay? All you're gonna do is just get creative. And I'm not gonna put every single stripe on. And go in different directions like that. And just have fun with it. To make like a Y, make any design that you want. I'll stripe the zebra's legs. Trying to go fast. I don't want to bore anybody with the zebra stripes, right, Jack?
No.
Did you ever see a zebra, Jack?
Never.
Never? Not even at the zoo?
I don't recall.
You don't recall?
I watch them on the Discovery.
Oh, on Discovery, yeah. Yeah. Now here, bring them down a little bit. Up, down, around. Just have fun with it. We're going pretty fast here. But you'll have time to take your time. I'm just going pretty fast here. Right here, I like to do something like this. Maybe a little stripe here under the zebra's eyes. Do one here. And maybe one more here. All right, we got our zebra. So this one here is one of my favorites. I use the highlighters. And you can make your zebra any color you want. As long as your zebra probably has the black stripes, that would probably be good. All right, and I used my highlighters again, sort of just scribbled to make a really cool zebra. So have fun with that one. All right, our last drawing. Is my, even though I love elephants and I love horses and zebras, guess what it is?
The unicorn.
The unicorn, yes. Yes. We're gonna go for a unicorn. I know so many people who love unicorns. And again, that's pretty much our template for the unicorn, okay? Ready? Let's switch it up here. I don't think we need this anymore. Let's find our unicorn. Okay. So, again, one more time. For our unicorn, we are going to start with, oh no, my marker's running out. Uh-oh. Maybe I should use a different color marker, huh? Okay. Do you want to read us some unicorn facts while I get a different marker?
I will.
You will.
Unicorn facts. A unicorn is a legendary, beautiful horse with a single horn. Unicorn's eyes are sky blue or purple.
Whoa.
Unicorns eat grass, berries, nuts, fruit, candy corn with grows on rainbows.
Candy corn grows on rainbows. No way.
Oh. The baby unicorn is called Sparkle. Unicorns live in a magical forest. When you see a unicorn, you will have good luck. If you make a wish, it is supposed to come true.
Wow.
Unicorns have magical powers, super speed, and unbelievable strength.
Super speed and unbelievable strength and magical powers. That is pretty awesome. Okay, one more time for our unicorn. There's our cylinder. There's our triangle. Here's our flag. Right here. More triangles and triangles. I'm using purple. Did you know that?
You have to.
Yeah. I'm using purple. Oh, and don't forget the unicorn's horn, right? Okay. So, from here, again, I'm going to use my finger to erase. And I'm going to go a little bigger here. And there we go. I'm going to erase. Sometimes it's easier to erase at the end. Sometimes it's not. Whatever works for you. Is there any way you can hold that right there for now? Okay. So then we're going to come down and we're going to do the other leg. And I'm going to erase this whole cylinder right here. And go up here and wiggle a little bit. Okay. That leg looks a little skinny. I think I'm going to make it a little bigger. Okay. Now, let's go to this triangle in the back. We'll put the hoof on. And there we go. We forgot to do this, but that's okay. That's why we have an eraser, right? Let's fix this one up. And one more leg. Okay. I've never seen a unicorn, have you, Jack?
I have one in my backyard.
You have a unicorn in your backyard? Oh my goodness, that's pretty lucky. I didn't know that. Okay, so we curved out a little bit. Now, we're gonna have fun here. We're gonna go like this, and I'm gonna make my unicorn smile. Bring that down a little bit. Let's get rid of this right here, and I'm gonna fix this up. That was just for proportion. Oops, let's do it one more time. There we go. I like that. Okay. Here's an ear. We don't really see the other ear. And I'm going to keep that. And I'm going to erase this part right here. Fix our unicorn up. I'm going to give my unicorn lots of a big wavy mane. Nice big wavy mane. Okay. Oh, let's move this. We forgot the unicorn's tail. Okay. You got it?
Yeah.
All right. And have fun with it. That's all that matters. Drawing is so relaxing. I can't believe that. Okay. I'm going to give my unicorn some eyelashes here. And I forget what color were their eyes. Sky blue?
Pink.
Okay. And go like that. Oh, we forgot to put some on his unicorn horn. We forgot to put some lines there. And is our unicorn by a rainbow looking for that candy corn? I think that's a unicorn treat, right? So put our unicorn right there. Now would be the time to fix it up. And I'm gonna fill in my unicorn a little bit. And I'm not gonna color too much because it's super hard to color on a wipe-off board. But, oops, we forgot to erase right here. Make sure you erase everywhere where you're supposed to erase. And what did we say, sky blue eyes, right?
Sky blue or purple.
Wow. Let's do a little bit like that, and maybe color in a little bit here. The mane. I like to give unicorns multicolors. And look at that one. That one has braids. What do you notice about that unicorn, Jack?
He has a
braids.
Braid. His hoofs are blue.
Yeah.
Put the rainbow on his hoofs.
You got some flower tattoos, right? Flower tattoos. And unicorns are pretty much always happy, I bet, right? I would be happy if I got to get candy corn from a rainbow all the time. Wouldn't you?
Would, if you remember his tail.
Yeah. Okay, so it's up to you to use whatever colors you want. I want to show you one more thing about a unicorn. Okay, let's put this one down. So this one we used with the cylinder and the triangles, just like the horse and the horse and the zebra, right? Oops. I'm on that dismiss. Okay, so now let's erase this one. Uh-oh. Not erasing too good with your eraser, huh? You gotta put some elbow grease in there. Okay. So, look at this one. Have fun with it. And can you hold that? Okay, move your fingers just a little bit. Okay, so check this one out. Here's my cylinder right here. Okay, and all I did was move my triangles around. Okay, so I moved the triangles around. So now this unicorn is definitely by the rainbow. Okay, and what I did, I took my highlighter and I just dotted. And I made a really, really fun, whimsical mane. And have fun with it. And that's what the point of drawing is, to have fun with it. So a lot of people say, I can't draw. Well, if you know your basic shapes and you can draw a oval, a cylinder, a circle, a triangle, a square, yes, you can. You can draw. I believe that everybody can draw. And have fun with it. Have fun with word art. Have fun with doodling. Doodling is relaxing if you're talking on the phone or if you're watching TV. Just have fun with it. All you need is, this is just a piece of Jack's computer paper. Okay, I know everybody has printer paper. So any type of paper will do. And you need a piece of paper, a pencil. This is just a regular number 2 pencil, and an eraser. Oh, and probably a pencil sharpener. Okay, so any of these drawings that I have, that Jack and I have showed you, can be turned into realistic, right? Even the unicorn can be realistic?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, we have one more thing to talk about, and then our time is just about up. Okay? One more thing that we want to talk about would be, where is it? I think it's probably, do you have it right here? I think it's over here. Okay, look at that. Wash often. What are we talking about?
Washing your hands.
Washing your hands. Jack's a plumber. You wash your hands a lot. Water's really important, right?
Yes, it is.
Okay, so water for the elephants, drink up the, what, 55 gallons of water? Okay. We need water. Everybody pretty much needs water, and especially right now, we need a lot of soap, a lot of bubbles, and we need to wash our hands really, really, really good, right?
Yes.
Do you want to say anything else about washing our hands?
When we wash our hands, we want to wash the fronts, we want to get in between your fingers, we want to get in the back, and you want to get your fingernails. And how I do it is I take a soap bar and put it under my fingernails, and I wipe it off. That's the way to be safe under these conditions.
Right. We want to be safe, and we want you to enjoy our lesson here, and we want you to relax, and we want you to have fun drawing. A great way to relax, like I said, is doodling, word art, write your name in big bubbles, try it in script, try it in block letters, make some hands, make some bubbles, make a faucet, whatever you want to make, as long as you're drawing and relaxing. All right, everybody, that's it for us. We want to say thanks for watching, and we had a lot of fun teaching you some of the lessons to draw. All right, everybody, we're going to sign off for now. Bye.